Back when the A220 was the Bombardier CSeries, designers had worked to bring airline customers a plane they would love. Feedback from potential customers was that they wanted a bigger cabin, larger windows, more space for baggage, and connectivity such as in-flight Wi-Fi designed in. Bombardier delivered all that and more in an airplane that was long-range, comfortable, capable, and efficient. Rob Dewar, a current VP at Airbus Canada, was one of the first three employees to be charged with designing the CSeries under Bombardier's New Commercial Aircraft Program, or NCAP. Since day one, his influence has shaped the CSeries and now the A220 from its initial design to the incremental improvements it's getting along the way. We asked Rob about the success of the A220. He told us he wasn't surprised at all. From the outset, Bombardier and later on Airbus have worked closely with airlines to make the aircraft exactly what they want. There have been some questions raised regarding the A220's range in the past, with some operators wondering if Airbus made it too long-legged to be as efficient as it could. European operators in particular weren't in need of an aircraft that was that small but could fly that far, given their focus on shorter missions. Nevertheless, American operators wanted something that could fly transcontinental, and so the aircraft was born with a sizable range. But then in 2019, Airbus announced an increased maximum takeoff weight, or MTOW, for both variants of the A220, which would be launched by the middle of 2020. In March 2021, Airbus added another 2.3 tons to the MTOW for the A220-300. The driver for this was one particular airline, as Rob explained.
But I have to tell you, it was really the Aussies, and Qantas in particular, said we want even more range. A little bit of a secret. So I actually did, I supported what the Aussies wanted, made a longer range aircraft. Of course, we had enough fuel volume, but we limited the max takeoff weight. And I was really waiting for Qantas to make the move to really, harvest what they asked for. And thank God they did, because I felt maybe we did something a bit too much.
Qantas did indeed respond to the A220's increased MTOW, confirming an order in May 2022 for 20 of the narrow-body jets. The increased MTOW of the A220 was a gamble, but it has certainly paid off for Airbus. Rob noted that it has been a popular modification that really came into its own during the pandemic.
No, really, everyone loves the range. And the pandemic really saw the power of that. That in the pandemic, people had to change many routes. And the 220 fared extremely well in the pandemic because, why? It could fly the longer range routes of the bigger single aisles. And basically do it at a much lower cost. So it actually even more, let's say, validated the range capability. And what airlines wants is flexibility. Can I take off on a short runway? Can I run the short routes? But can I also run those long routes or any combination thereof? So it is reducing the risk of them from a network point of view that gives them full options on what they need to do,
CEO Alan Joyce described the A220 as the, quote, backbone of our domestic fleet for the next 20 years, in tandem with the A321 XLRs ordered at the same time. In February this year, the airline added 9 more A220s to the order book, solidifying its commitment and confidence in the jet. What do you think of the A220 having its range extended? Share your thoughts by leaving a comment. In addition to our daily YouTube videos, Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.